colored line you can see on the ground is the ideal trajectory. It changes color depending on the speed with which you approach a corner. If it goes red, that means you have to slow down. The black marks on the track are where the track has been rubbered in. Bikes leave the marks by riding over the same part of the track again and again. Riding on the marks improves grip. Different simulation levels to suit every kind of rider. Just now, you're racing at semi-pro simulation level. Let's try at a base simulation level. As you can tell, the bike now has some assisted controls, and it's easier to ride. If you fall or make a mistake, you can press the rewind button to go back in time and make amends. Be careful, though. There are only a limited number of rewinds available. Now let's have a go at the pro simulation level, suitable for experienced riders. Physics has become more realistic. What's more, you can now control the brakes separately. Simulation levels this high, it becomes essential to understand how to regulate the TCS. This is an anti-slip system that, acting on the rear wheel, helps you stay on the bike during acceleration. You can adjust its intensity at any time. One last thing. Normally, coming into a straight, the rider tucks into the fairing for a more aerodynamic position. This option can be set to manual. Let's give it a go. all you need to know to start racing and ride. You can leave this tutorial from the pause menu. Or if you prefer, you can carry on free training at the pro simulation level. See you on the track.